Hey guys, you ain't got buns here, and today we're going to be putting DS3 and Elden Ring head-to-head in various different comparisons to see which comes out on top. Quick PSA, a lot of people seem to forget that an opinion is an opinion, because not everyone is going to agree on it, and regardless of who wins, both these games pitch a tent taller than Mount Everest for me. These games are damn near perfect in my opinion. Also, shout out to my boy Syntax for the thumbnail. Bro's an absolute wizard with the Photoshop. I'm going to put his at in the description. Check him out. But yeah, with the intro done, let's get into the video. So first, I'm going to be talking about DS3's visuals as a whole, and then Elden Ring's, which I will do with every other comparison. So first off, the medieval castle style that comprised the majority of the architecture was absolutely astonishing, and had some of the most depth and creativity I've seen in the Souls series. Felt like I was fucking Frodo Baggins, because I was just constantly checking out all these sick, crazy different areas, plus I'm like 5'7", so... I also love the Ashes of Arendelle, even though it's kind of unfair to put it in here because I haven't played the Elden Ring DLC yet. Another part of the visuals I'd like to bring up is the background visuals. DS3 had some awesome fucking background. For example, at the High Wall of Lothric, just looking down at the fucking city below you was really fucking cool. There's a lot of areas like that in DS3. That's one of my favorite things about the visual style. Elden Ring has that too, but I feel like somehow DS3 just did it better. My opinion. They might have not been the most highly textured, but the game's been out for like 10 years, so let's cut it some slack. And for that reason, I'm going to cut it some slack, actually, for this whole video. But yeah, I think that just about covers my favorite parts of the DS3 visuals. It was really just a style, for real. I really like the style of DS3. It was really cool. But what Elden Ring lacked in architecture, they did not lack in map visuals. DS3 did not have very appealing looking levels, so to say, to me, unless you were in a castle, which a lot of the time you are, but otherwise, it's just kind of gross looking, really. But Elden Ring has a beautiful map, even for its size. It is a very full map, and each area seems to always have great blending of the terrain with the buildings, as well as the small details around the map, like trees, fences, just shit like that. But in my opinion, besides the high resolution, which is due to Elden Ring being so recent, I'm going to have to say DS3 has better visuals, which could come as a surprise to a lot of you. But I think I like DS3's as a whole quite a bit more, really. There were way more jaw-dropping moments from the badass area surrounding me in DS3 than any game I've ever played. Elden Ring had a lot, but DS3 had more. Couldn't stop admiring it, honestly. Dark Souls 3 contains the greatest designs and style of any of the Soulsborne games, in my opinion. Combat is, in many people's eyes, the most important aspect of a Souls game, including myself. The combat of DS3 has a very fast playstyle. It's more like a... snorting a line of cocaine and popping an Adderall up your ass. In comparison to Elden Ring, where you kind of have more like a blunt in your hand and half a Xanax hanging out your nose. But it's really not that slow. That's a little dramatic, honestly. You definitely have to wait a bit longer to get off a move and get the chance to use a move in general. Not that that's a bad thing, but the faster playstyle does feel more enjoyable for the most part. DS3 also has a very well-crafted combat system, as the rolling is super strong. Almost a little too strong, but I do enjoy it. It's a good roll. It's fun. But you will still get punished for rolling poorly, and the attacking portion of the combat is great as well. Attacking in DS3 generally deals less damage than you would in Elden Ring fight, but you can attack much more than you would in Elden Ring 2 because your weapons are so much faster. This creates a very fun, almost like euphoric boss fight with you constantly trying to take down the boss's health bar instead of just getting a lot of damage at a large opening. Alright, now time for Elden Ring. Elden Ring has a much more slow-paced fighting style than DS3, as you are normally basing your damage on status effects or weapons that deal a significant amount of damage. Whether that be a charge attack from a greatsword or an onslaught of jabs from a rapier, and the times you are normally able to get an attack off, you normally get quite a few due to the bosses seeming to do many combos over and over, with you attacking at the end of each combo with a big opening. While this is satisfying, it doesn't really give off the same crack addict feeling that a DS3 boss fight does, because you're so immersed in the experience and the speed at which everything is happening while still being extremely focused the entire time. It just brings about a very enjoyable experience. So as you would probably assume, DS3 is going to take this one too. The combat, in my opinion, just feels more fun. By level design, I'm referring to how enemies are placed in a level, how that level is laid out, and how enjoyable the overall level is. Good thing for DS3 because it would not be getting much love in that regard. But there were a few things I did enjoy, however, those being how the levels always had unique shortcuts and always seemed to wrap back into themselves while still giving a very good sense of direction to progress further. And honestly, that's it. For the things I don't like, easily the biggest thing for me is the amount of enemies and how annoying the fucking enemies in that game are. I lost my fucking mind trying to get through those areas, whether it be the 69 teleporting dogs at my heels or the lizard chain axe fuckers legitimately trick scoping you off the fucking high rise while their little minions combo you back to KFC to get a side of fries with the 10-piece combo they throw at you. And then also they shoot fucking fireballs because why not, right? Now, Elden Ring doesn't necessarily have levels, but it is set up in that type of way, with areas you entering kind of just being levels themselves, like Stormveil Castle, Laendell, shit like that. Now, one thing Elden Ring's open world does a great favor to the player is that there is a much bigger gap between the majority of enemies and plenty of areas to escape to. The level design of Elden Ring also includes the same concept of the level wrapping back into itself, but I think DS3 did a much better job at it. Elden Ring also has a fairly good sense of direction. It can get confusing sometimes, though. Elden Ring's levels also seem to have quite a bit more depth, as you can go to pretty much anything your eyes can see, and the levels are full of items and weapons. Elden Ring does level design very, very well. It's just not really something I can elaborate much more on, so, and possibly starting its comeback. Now this one, like the last one, is going to be an absolute fucking landslide. DS3 really doesn't have much quality of life, honestly. It's very bare bones compared to what Elden Ring implemented. Elden Ring brought in Stakes of America, so you don't have to suffer boss runbacks, the ability to teleport from anywhere to anywhere, and you can just generally have so much more quality of life going for you in Elden Ring with plenty of tiny things I could bring up, but there's really no point. Elden Ring's taking this one freely. Now, I know Elden Ring is a lot more recent, obviously. I brought that up earlier, but, I mean, there have been quality of life tests throughout all of the Souls games, and Elden Ring just did them all. Did all of the best ones, and for that, I'm going to give it a point. It's all tied up, folks, and we saved my favorite part of the Dark Souls franchise for last. The boss fights. Once again, we'll be starting with DS3. DS3's boss fights are fucking exquisite. They're like a cold glass of lemonade on a hot summer day, but the sugar used to make the lemonade was actually fucking cocaine. The bosses are fucking awesome and so hype. They're genuinely intimidating, and they have awesome movesets and concepts. This paired with the fast-paced playstyle creates some of the most satisfying and enjoyable fights in gaming history. Gale was my favorite boss of DS3, probably not just me, but also the one I struggled with the most. Gale was the perfect fucking final boss. He was fucking awesome from his moveset, to the lore you learn about him, and the cutscenes you watch of him. Just everything associated with this fight was absolutely perfect. Not to say every boss in DS3 was this way, however. There were definitely some stinkers who made the roses around them smell like shit. But there were very few, those being the Cursed Rotted Great Wood, which was just so fucking boring and tedious because you just had to smack all the fucking STDs off of them. And the High Lord Wolnir, who was the easiest boss probably ever. It's like stealing candy from a baby, but you're stealing a giant boner spleen. For the most part, those are the only really two bad bosses in my opinion, though. The vast majority were very well designed, whether that be visually or the fight itself. So, let's talk about Elden Ring's bosses. Elden Ring did not have the same showing for a final boss as DS3. I know Gale isn't technically the final boss as the Soul of Cinder actually is, but that boss was fucking awesome too. Like, that shit was my favorite before Gale, and honestly, I don't really even know which I like more. They are both my two favorite bosses ever, so... But either way, they're both definitely cooler and better than Radabeast. Elden Beast is a slow, giant, fucking weak-ass dildo. Radagon is very cool, arguably my favorite boss from Elden Ring besides Moog, even if he is a bloody pillow. Yeah, because the Lord of Blood. Anyway, Elden Ring kind of fumbled on the final boss, not gonna lie, but what about the bosses as a whole? Well, Elden Ring's bosses, for the most part, are all very cool and unique characters with great boss fights as well. Every single boss in Elden Ring, I will say, is very balanced and very well-rounded. That is for sure. In DS3, that is not always the case. But something about the Elden Ring boss fights just doesn't feel the same. Feels like it's missing the intimidating aura the bosses of DS3 had, and the fast-paced gameplay makes the boss fights feel all the more enjoyable. I think Elden Ring has great bosses, but DS3 has better. With that, Dark Souls 3 has officially claimed the win from the skin of its sack with a score of 3-2. I personally agree with that outcome, as I did enjoy DS3 quite a bit more than Elden Ring. It feels like DS3 is that badass older brother that doesn't really follow the rules and wears eyeliner and his motorcycle, whereas Elden Ring's like the gifted athletic kid in the family where he just does everything perfectly, but he's just missing the grit and the dick size. of the badass older brother. I still do, and forever will, love Elden Ring. I think Elden Ring is a better game, just not as fun. I didn't enjoy it as much, to be honest. I think if DS3 came out today, it would no question be the best Dark Souls game ever made, in my opinion. Still is, but that's just my opinion. Feel free to comment yours down below. I generally respond to every comment, especially about shit like this, so just be respectful to everyone else in there, please, and please like and sub if you enjoyed. The support I've been getting lately means the world to me, and each of you commenting on and supporting my channel make my day every day. And also, I just want to say I am very sorry I haven't posted in so long. I got a new job, and I've just been really stressed out. You know how it is, being fucking mentally disordered and shit. But, yeah, I really, like, every comment I see, I mean, granted, it's like once a week at this point because I haven't posted in so long. Every comment I see is very nice, and it just inspires me to make a video every time. So, I really do appreciate it. It means genuinely the world to me. Also, I am very soon going to be recording a video on the DLC. So, if you want to see me try that, it will literally be the first time on this channel that I've played something that I haven't played a million times already. So, if you want to see that, hit that notification bell, or just be on the lookout for it, I guess. But yeah, guys, I really hope you all have a great day, and I really hope you enjoyed. Peace.